Good evening. Biotechnological aspect continues in this particular part also. So, genetically engineered food items permitted to import in India is only that soya and canola oils. So, both the things we can import from other country. India at present importing soybean oil from Argentina, Brazil and Paraguay, and a small quantity of the canola oil from the Canada. So that import regulations, everything is regulated as per the Environmental Protection Act 1986. So that is a foundation for India's biotechnology regulatory framework for genetically engineered plants, animal and their product and byproducts. In continuation of that particular EPA Act, right now we have a genetic engineering appraisal committee that is affects regulatory body. So that must conduct an appraisal of all biotech food and agriculture products and products derived from the biotech plants or other biotech organisms prior to commercial approval or importation by Government of India. So that a genetic engineering appraisal committee is the regulatory authority. So the import of genetically engineered seeds and planting materials is also regulated by the Plant Quarantine Order 2003. So in the Plant Quarantine Order regulate the import of germplasm, bioengineered organisms, transgenic materials for research purpose. After getting import permit from the National Bureau of Plant Genetic Resources, so NBPGR is authorized authority for issuing the import permit for genetically engineered seeds and plant material. On August 24, 2006, Government of India enacted Integrated Food Law in the name of Food Safety and Standards Act of 2006, which has a specific provision for regulating genetically engineered food products, including processed foods. So genetically engineered material received for the purpose of food means that the FSSI, they are responsible to check the quality. And then GE material, genetically engineered material ready for release in India is on October 14, 2009, that genetic engineering approval committee, they recommended approval of commercial cultivation of the PT eggplant to the Ministry of Environment and Forest. That final decision not yet arrived. Similarly, on 2016, a genetic engineering approval committee, they forwarded that Delhi University developed GE mustard variety. So for development of that mustard variety, they followed that Parnase, Parstar and Pargin technology. So that material also not yet released. On May 2017, genetic engineering approval committee approved the environmental release of the locally developed genetic engineering mustard. So all of them in a proposal stage, not yet accepted for cultivation in the field level. Then role of various ministries or state government with reference to that genetic engineering plants. So in that Minister of Environment Forest, they are housed with that genetic engineering approval committee. So that committee is a nodal agency responsible for implementation of the biotech rules of 1989 under the Environment Protection Act. And then DBT, Department of Biotechnology, they provide guidelines and technical support to the genetic engineering approval committee, evaluates, approves biosafety assessment of the genetic engineering products, research and development in the country. Then Ministry of Agriculture and Family Welfare, so they are responsible for conducting that field trial, reference to that transgenic crop varieties. And also they are responsible for conducting that post-approval monitoring also. Then FSSAI, so they evaluate and approve the safety assessment of the genetic engineering crops and products for human consumption. But that FSSAI, they are not yet established the regulation. So because of that genetic engineering approval committee, they are continues to oversee this responsibility. And then PT cotton event approved so far in India is Cry 1 AC, that is MON MON531. This material is developed by the Maiko Monsanto Biotech Limited. So for this purpose, they used gene from Monsanto. So this material is accepted for fiber, seed and feed usage. And another one is Cry1AC and Cry2AB. So that is a event is MON15985. Developer is Maiko Monsanto Biotech Limited. That material also accepted to use fiber, seed and feed. That gene source is stacked gene event sourced from the Monsanto. Then Cry1AC event 1 and developer is JK Agri Genetics. So this also accepted for the same purpose. That gene source is from Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur, that is IIT Kharagpur. Then Cry1AB, Cry1AC, the event name is GFM event. The developer is North Seed. So that gene source is from China Futuring Fused Genes. Then another one is Cry1AC, that event name is PNLA1. The developer is Central Institute of Cotton Research. Then Cry1C, the even name is MLS9124, Metahelix Life Science Private Limited. So these are all the materials approved by the Government of India for commercial cultivation at field level. Then PT cotton, the only genetically modified crop approved for commercial cultivation in India. So this occupy around 95% of the cotton growing area of India, and that yield estimate also somewhere around 26.5 million bales the year 2018-19, out of which 3.5 million bales will be exported to outside. Then genetic engineering cotton seeds, which includes Monsanto's insect and herbicide tolerant material, that is Polkod 2 Roundup Ready Flux, that is PG2RRF. Then India is the world largest exporter of the cotton. So third largest exporter of the cotton. The first is USA, the second one is Brazil, next to that India. With reference to that export of that PT based cotton fiber is concerned, no need to get any genetic engineering declaration done, because the fiber and all, it's a cellulosic material, no protein going to be there. Further, that fiber is not used for feed or food purpose. So because of that, for export or import of the cotton fibers made out of that genetically engineered crops, no need to get any GE declarations. In order to regulate that sale price of that cotton seed after introduction of the PT in India, the Government of India, they passed Cotton Seed Price Control Order in the name of CSPCO, the year 2015, on December 7, mainly to regulate the maximum sale price of cotton, including royalty, a trade value, and prescribing licensing guidelines and permit for all the GM technology licensing agreements. On March 8, 2016, the ministry fixed a rate for Polkod 1 cotton is ₹635 per packet. So per packet that consists of 450 gram of PT seeds and 120 gram of that non-PT, refugia seeds. There won't be any trade value. For Polkod 2 cotton, they fixed the price of 800 per packet, with the trade value of ₹49 per packet. So that cotton seed price control order is in operation. So that now that Government of India, they are controlling that sale price of the cotton seeds. In some aspects related to that animal biotechnology, so on February 6, 2009, that NDRI, National Dairy Research Institute, delivered the first cloned buffalo hybrid calf by following that advanced hand-guided cloning techniques. Subsequently, two clones were delivered on June 6, 2009 and August 22, 2010. And then December 2015, that NDRA, they claimed they have successfully produced a female clone of endangered wild buffalo of Chhattisgarh. On March 9, 2012, scientists from Sri Kashmir University of Agriculture Sciences and Technology at Srinagar, they claimed to have delivered a cloned pashmina coat by the same cloning technique, that is advanced hand-aided cloning techniques. Then Aqua Poundi salmon, this is another important historical one. So the Aqua Poundi, they got a US FDA approval, that is Food and Drug Administration approval for the for Atlantic salmon with modified growth hormone expressions. So normally they are producing this particular salmon by adding genes from Sinuk salmon. So Sinuk salmon genes are responsible for double the size of the traditional Atlantic salmon over the same period, as well as another gene, that is a DNA from ocean pout, that is an eel-like fish. And the important thing with reference to this event is concerned, this is a first genetically modified animal allowed by the FDA to be raised and sold commercially in the US. Then some diagnostic kits also developed by the animal health side, that is Central Institute of Fishery and Technology. They developed right detection kit for detecting the presence of the ammonia and formalin in fish. Similarly, that IVRA, they developed a Japanese encephalitis ELISA kit for detection of that swine flu population in animals. And IVRA blue tongue sandwich ELISA, that is S. ELISA, for detection of the antigen in sheep, goat, cattle, buffalo and camel for blue tongue, which is normally insect transmitted viral disease. In that sandwich ELISA and Japanese encephalitis ELISA developed under the Make in India programs. Then ICRCAFT developed a freshness dot smart and easy to use paper based indicator to detect the freshness of the fish and shellfishes. So these are the things I wanted to convey to you in the second part with reference to biotechnology. Thank you very much.